Hello, welcome to the Self-Learning Podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 28, Writing Up Qualitative Data. And our topic is Grasp and then Render. Clifford Greaves, in his famous article that advocated the idea of thick description, says that the field worker first of all grasps and then renders. Grasping is done using a set of techniques and methods, the toolkit of anthropologists. In his standard textbook on anthropological methods, Palto writes that the field worker does not have at his disposal a fixed assemblage of techniques, arrayed in a particular manner. What he knows are the generic types of fieldwork techniques and methods that he has acquired as a part of his theoretical training. But he also knows, as we have said earlier, that each fieldwork is not only unique, it is also the experiment with the basic fieldwork techniques and methods. Whether a specific technique or method is useful in a particular fieldwork situation will depend upon the conditions prevailing in the community under study at that point of time. Depending upon the context of study, the field workers will combine various techniques and methods. He may also improvise new techniques and methods or make a significant contribution to the already existing toolkit. An important part of the sociological writings is an account of one's experiences of handling the repertoire of techniques and methods in a field work. Rendering is what we give to the world of academics, to the public, and to all those concerned. We can render through a broad range of activities, such as we may write academic reports, articles, monographs. We may deliver lectures and make seminar presentations on our studies. We may show slides, pictures, films, videos that we have prepared on the people of our study. We may narrate stories about the people or recite poems who we wrote on them or during the field work. We may exhibit local material, cultural artifacts, and give their descriptions. We may appear on a TV talk show and talk about our field studies. We may write for newspapers and popular journals, or write a script for an ethnographic play or fiction, or just chat about our studies and the people of those studies in pubs. In other words, all these options are viable and field workers often resort to them. But of these, the most important and also academically uplifting is the realm of publications, which includes books, articles, and monographs, the pieces of serious research. In the world of academics, no substitute exists for publications. There was a time when writing was the only thinkable way of presenting the results of one's fieldwork. Now, other ways have come into existence, and in recent years, we also write for certain websites, write e-books. Earlier, we wrote longhand or on the typewriter. Now, the technology of writing has changed. We write on computer or use a dictaphone. The taped text being transcribed later. We also tape our lectures, then transcribe, edit, and publish them. We create our renderings of fieldwork in classes and lecture theaters, and let films and photographs are valued, for they augment our standard ethnography. But they are not supposed to replace the letter. A picture may be highly expressive, worth a million words, but words come first and pictures are optional. A coffee table book with dozens of pictures and their captions is not counted an ethnography or a monograph on people of one's study. On the place of picture in the written up text for publication. It is abundantly clear from the above that the issues of writing up are as important and significant as are the issues of fieldwork, of rapport, establishment and handling the methods and techniques of data collection. While a lot exists on how fieldwork was carried out, there is hardly anything available on one's experience of writing up, on one's problem and crisis pertaining to what has come to be known as desk work. Becker notes that the teachers do not tell the students how the textbooks and the monographs they read are actually written. Most students, he says, never have an opportunity to actually see their teachers or professional writers and authors or researchers at desk work. And also the authors and writers do not write on their writing experience of producing a text. However, in the last two decades, some authors have seriously attended to this topic. They clearly state that the aspects of writing up need to be discussed as explicitly as possible. Undoubtedly, some researchers are far more creative than others and have a flair for writing, but one can examine the matter of writing up objectively, suggesting useful points that one must bear in mind. Notwithstanding one's level of creativity in writing, that writing regularly can increase one's creative potential has time and again been emphasized in many of these works. In this connection, one is advised to consult the following two texts: Howard Becker's Writing for Social Scientists, How to Start and Finish Your Thesis, Book or Article, and Harry Walcott, Writing Up Qualitative Research. Walcott, The Art of Field Work, also has a chapter on writing up, which is highly recommended, and so is Laurel Richardson's paper titled Writing a Method of Inquiry. Now let us move to the next point, writing down and writing up. Writing up is the process whereby world is transformed into words. By the world is understood the ethnographic landscape, where the investigator spends a lengthy period of time, generally not less than an annual cycle, observing and interviewing people in their natural habitat. During this period of fieldwork, the investigator sees, feels, hears, smells and tastes the other, the object of study, He or she is also imagines many things about the other. Chances upon the tentative explanations of the various phenomena. Test certain well-known theories on the facts at his or her disposal, and records in the mind as well as the on the paper his or her experience of collecting data. He or she also spends out from the field letters and now emails to supervisors, project directors, kin persons and friends. They all constitute a part of data, a first-hand account of experiences of knowing the other, for the meaning of the team or the other. Murevex says that the writing is not simply an adjunct to field work, but is its critical component. But this writing is writing down the notes, the observations, excerpts for interviews. It is the pretext stage. It is like collecting, gathering and accumulating the ingredients and transforming them into a cuisine. If one takes an analogy from the culinary art, researchers know that the collection of data and the ethnographic writings are not only analytical separable, but also can be distinguished into a number of ways. However, it is on the first that the second is built up. The first one is data and the second one is ethnography. We write down. The common expression is note down. The facts in our notebooks and field diaries which constitute our data. In addition to the factual details that we have written down, a lot exists in our minds, in our memories, for which Simon Ottenberg has used the term head notes. The pieces of information embedded in our heads surface when we are in the process of writing. Our head notes help us in interpreting and understanding the facts that we have collected. That is why when a sociologist reads other ethnographers' notes, he finds it difficult to understand them, because he lacks the head notes that facilitate understanding. When we are in the process of writing up a text, we realize that what we have collected in our notes and diaries is not really complete, for much exists in our memories and can always be called for at relevant places and times. We write down field notes, but we write up the ethnographic text. Let us have a look at the distinction between the write down and write up. According to the Random House Dictionary of the English Language, write down is to set down in writing, record notes. Its other meaning is to direct one's efforts in writing to a lower level, as to less intelligent reader or audience. The example given here is, he writes down to the public. Write up is to put into writing, especially in full detail. The example appended is, to write up a report. Thinking in terms of their meanings, we can say that the facts are recorded, they are written down, scribbled and scratched. In her writing, Margaret Mead discusses the pressure on field workers to prepare field notes from scratch notes, and also the danger of the scratch notes turning cold and uninteresting when the process of writing them down is delayed, even a day by a day. She also notices the satisfaction that a field worker gets on catching up with the writing down of scratch and head notes. From the written down notes and the unwritten memories from the field, the investigator writes up the qualitative account, the piece of ethnography. Write down to write up is also a transition from field work to desk work, from the hurly-burly field to a quiet workroom. Through writing up, the first-hand field experience are transformed into a text, a report, a monograph, or an article. At this juncture, we may ask a question: is the transition from write down to write up as smooth as it appears? Furthermore, pursuing the analogy of a kitchen, as different cooks prepare different cuisines from the same raw ingredients, in the same way, different field workers produce different ethnographies from the same reservoir of facts. It should also be remembered here that the social facts collected by two different field workers from the same ethnographic situation are never the same. For different theoretical perspective, color each one's vision. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.